Most of New South Wales will experience a heat wave.
Temperatures will reach 45 degrees in many parts of the state today.
Several kids have been seriously injured after everyday objects like play equipment and synthetic grass became dangerously hot.
Heat kills more people in Australia than any natural disaster. And part of the solution could be right over our heads.
The type of homes that we're building is going to decide how many people get sick or even die in the severe heat waves of our future.
Parts of the highly urbanised areas may become uninhabitable over the next decades.
Western Sydney is among the most heat-affected regions of Australia. Rapid development means less green space and more of the stuff that traps heat: concrete, asphalt, and dark roof tiles.
We have data for black roofs that get to about 80 degrees Celsius, not Fahrenheit, Celsius, on a relatively normal summer day. Other very hot surfaces that we find, for example, in parks and playgrounds, are rubber surfaces and also synthetic turf. These surfaces I measured above 100 degrees Celsius, so they become heat hazards.
Dark roofs and black bitumen create a so-called heat island effect by absorbing heat and radiating it back into homes and air on city streets.
Dark surfaces can make surface temperature up to 30 degrees hotter than lighter coloured surfaces on roofs.
Last year, the New South Wales government planned to ban dark roofs to reduce temperatures and energy costs for new homes.
A policy switch to ensure that all new housing has light-coloured roofing, whatever shade you want, would have an enormous impact on the urban heat island effect in our city, and I'm asking the Department of Planning to implement this as part of our net zero cities approach.
But it's an idea that went nowhere, seemingly scrapped by his successor, Anthony Roberts. In a statement to the project this week, a spokesperson from the Department of Planning and Environment said there has never been a ban on dark roofs, nor has there ever been a proposal to do so. Dark roofs are still allowed, but would need to be offset as a disincentive, for example, including more insulation. That's a long way from what Rob Stokes suggested.
There are no practical reasons why we shouldn't be ditching dark roofing on new homes permanently.
It fills me with grief. I can't put it any other way. The science was really clear about the contribution that we can make to save energy and keep our suburbs cooler by just changing the colour of the roof.
Ian's lived in Western Sydney his whole life and has endured his fair share of heat waves. It can be more than 10 degrees hotter in his neighbourhood than in Sydney's eastern suburbs.
We would love to live closer to our workplaces or our schools, our universities, etc. But the reality is the rent is cheaper than in other affluent parts of Sydney.
The apartment Ian rents with his girlfriend has air conditioning, but when it's stinking hot, he'll often escape to a local shopping centre or library to stay cool and keep electricity costs down.
Energy bills have gone up maybe at least a quarter of what it was in the last year, and so if this continues, then it's going to be a continuing problem for families to try and keep afloat.
In Western Sydney, a light-coloured roof could reduce temperatures inside the home by 4 degrees on average and up to 10 degrees during a heatwave. Research also suggests ditching dark roofing could see temperatures across all of Sydney drop by up to 2.4 degrees.
People want higher standards for new homes to make them cool in future summers. They also want to see minimum standards for rental homes. It means better insulation and double glazing, eaves, lighter coloured roofs. Cheaply built housing is not affordable living.
Changing surfaces, surface colours, surface types, and introducing greening are very good techniques. We can't just paint one or two roofs. We have to paint thousands and thousands of roofs. We have to plant millions of trees to actually help people to transform their home from a hot box into something that is livable.
You know, I'm not a town planner or anything, but I wonder if we could solve this by putting sort of solar panels on roofs. Would that help maybe? And then maybe that'd power the air conditioning.
That seems really sensible here.
I don't know, it just feels...
That's not how we do policy.
Okay. Okay, let's just keep painting them dark colours then and ruining our lives.
You've got no future in politics, my friend.